Holy fuck! Holy fucking shit! Oh. Oh.
Hey, for real, no bullshit. That was a really good track.
Touching, great message, great violin,
great delivery. Keys.
I'm fucking done! Fuck this shit!
Because the people won't know. The people don't know. Most people don't know who this artist is.
Yo. This is an artist who broke into the Australian
scene through the help of Triple J with Triple J's radio station. Mm-hmm. Through a track he did, I think it was called Like You or something with Gosling. Did really well, and then it continued to... He's one of Australia's biggest rappers, correct? Pushed his album, Falling and Flying, to do big numbers. And yes, he is one of Australia's biggest rappers, if not the biggest right now. But yeah, Falling and Flying was his breakout album. It did really well. He started off with a single with Pez, the festival song, which was trash, but it did well.
It was what?
It wasn't the best. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. And yeah, he actually, in my opinion, made a good album with Falling and Flying. It was a good album. It had good production. It had fun lyrics, but also had a lot of in-depth, like, tackling things like suicide and death as well. So it was a really good album.
But then he dropped his next album. And it was one of the worst pieces of shit I've ever heard. Laced with really poppy beats, like really like cringy vocals, barely any topics that were worth even listening to because the production just waived any opportunity of wanting to give it an actual fuck. And that's all I've heard.
And now 360 recently released a album called Vintage Modern. So this will give you guys an understanding into a bit of Australian hip hop. One of Australia's biggest hip hop artists. I've never listened to a full album from his. You have. Some people really shit on this album and this artist.
So I'm going to be straight up.
We got to be.
As much as I want to shit on this album, if I'm enjoying it, I'm going to say I'm enjoying it. And I hope I do, honestly, because Falling and Flying was a dope album. And this guy does have shit he can say, so.
360, Vintage Modern. Let's have a look what this is. This will be interesting.
Let's get it.
White Lies. Yeah, I am naturally gifted. They hate that, they do. I'm attracted to women, homie, straight facts. Woke up one morning with a face tat. But when it comes to rappers, dog, I'm the softest one now. I'm the type to shadow box and get knocked the fuck out. I was the bright eyed, fine eyed in my prime time. Living life like the shit had never skydived.
There are some good lines in there.
There's some fucking corny lines in there. Fuck off.
Let me finish. There are some good lines in there. But a majority of this track was corny as fuck and...
What the fuck was that singing shit? What was that?
The hook was terrible. The beat was... I like how one of his lines were, I'm here to come back with this rap shit. You come back with the most poppiest beat possible. It was like, and even when like it switched up, it felt like it was like a Mumford & Sons indie sort of track.
Yeah, the beat was real confusing. I mean, does he think it suits him? I think a part of me think it suits him, but...
I think it does suit him. But I just feel like the...
I don't particularly enjoy that type of sound.
There was a crowd for this sort of music, like this sort of production with this sort of fun, sort of childish sort of wordplay.
Yeah, I agree.
There's a fan base for that sort of stuff.
But we didn't particularly enjoy that.
I like the line about having a foot fetish and getting off on the wrong foot.
Yeah.
I thought that was a funny line.
A lot of the line
about having a small dick with large foreskin filling up a bottle or some shit. I was like, okay.
But you know, that's what I like. Actually, positive. Like, I actually like that part of him. Like, he's self-deprecating. He doesn't take himself too seriously.
He's always been like that.
You know, he said he's soft. And I'm like, all right, is this going to be like a wordplay? How you're really hard? Because rappers usually like that. You know, I'm you know, that hard exterior.
Yeah,
no.
Yeah.
He's the softest out there. And he said it. I'm like, okay. It's kind of like, he doesn't take himself too seriously, pokes fun at himself. I like that.
Yeah, exactly. There's no, I'm not. It's not terrible. It's just bad.
You have lost the plot. What are we fighting for? We need to come together, but they divide us more. I've been in rock bottom, it's cold and nothing's there. I know you must be scared, but it's only up from here. It's time to knuckle down and get a handle on it though. Cause anytime you fail, that becomes a chance for you to grow.
When I'm ready to go, when I'm under pressure, cause I'm trying to find a way out, but there's something in the way.
Nothing to lose when you finally believe that it's a blessing just to feel. They say you can't, that just reaffirms you definitely will.
But I'm laying down, laying down, laying down for nothing.
Do you not like dubstep music? Is that, you'd call it dubstep?
It's not dubstep.
What do you call it? Electric? Electro? What do you
just
call
electro
it?
Electro dance. I call it dance.
Dance hall?
I just dance.
Okay. Do you not like typically
just
like that type of
pop
music?
Pop dance. I like it when it's done right, but very rarely. Like, that's why a lot of, if you notice on a lot of reviews, people be like, oh, like, you're shitting on it just because it's pop or just because it's radio friendly. It's true. It's just because I don't like that sound. It's saturated throughout radio. And when you do radio for a certain amount of years, you hear so much of that music and you're forced to play a lot of that music. Depending on what you're doing, of course. But yeah. So that's the problem I have with 360 here. He actually had some really good verses. He had some really good bars. He was spitting some good things, I thought. Some good sort of self-awareness and also, you know, some uplifting. That's one thing he's always been. He's always been a rapper that makes you really feel uplifted, really makes you want to, like, you know, do better with yourself or push yourself more. So I really like that aspect of him. But the beat's trash. The hook is trash. Ugh, it's just so fucking poppy with, like, a touch of indie to him.
But there's, like, I feel like there's nothing, like that's fine. Like, that's, like, you may not enjoy it, but there's nothing, like, technically, sonically, I don't think there's anything wrong with that.
No,
like, that,
no,
I think that works for him.
It works for him, and also there'll be, like I said before, there'll be people out there that like this sort of music, and there's a good message to go with it. So, it's a good track for people out there that like this sort of stuff, but to me, I don't really like it.
Well, you've been getting them wrong. Put a knife in your back to get ahead in the job. You've been definitely getting them wrong. All this hatred, where the hell did they been getting? Don't get jelly when they win though. Anytime they kill and go and cheer for them. Don't be happy when they get low. Hit them up and let them know you're here for them. Throw your hands, what you getting ready for? Never been
spoken by, spoken by.
Yeah, I know it hurts to get backstabbed. Your first reaction, you wanna go and snap back. Doesn't work, there's nothing worse.
So you changed. Yesterday I set my friend off you.
Are you regretting it yet? You regretting it?
Not yet, no. Because this is my idea. I really wanted to list this. We had a couple people ask us, but I really wanted to get uncomfortable and listen to something different.
See, the reason I didn't want to do this is because there's a lot of Australian artists out there that would deserve this way more than this guy does. But, you know, It's good we're doing it.
I think we got to do it at least once, right?
Right, we got to do it at least once.
We got to, like, taste him at least once. Pause. But, pause.
Same thing as last track. Good message. Don't like the beat.
Okay, a couple things. I don't even know where to start, man.
These hooks, these beats. Oh, it's just like he's trying so hard to be a genre that just doesn't work.
Like, this isn't just hip hop. This is like a hip hop, rock, pop, electro album.
Even, like, yeah, he might have a good message, but the delivery, I'm learning things. His delivery is such, it's so simple. And it's not even a bad thing, but it's like, it's so simple that it's like, it leaves you more to be desired. Like, in a world where I love technical rapping, I love how rappers craft their wordplay.
A majority of people out there that aren't big music fans that just want an easy listening song with an easy message, it's just, this is where
it caters to that. Mm-hmm. Respect. That's empathy.
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly.
But, like, if you really want to be great in music, right? And he's real. It's weird because it's like he's really hit the Australian scene big.
Yeah.
And for me, like, I don't really see what he's doing that's so special. Like, he's catering to a certain sound. I guess a lot of the average person finds that interesting.
I think also just the way that he raps. Like you said from the start, the way that he's, like, so, like, you know, he makes fun of himself a lot. He's quite open a lot. I feel like he does that in a way that not many other rappers do.
Okay.
So that's been straight up. He's just different in that regard. So that's definitely what catches.
Your expensive taste, ay, living it up, no giving a fuck. All you wanted is $1 million, spending every little bit.
bigger than mine, and Joey, you're richer than us. Yep, China's a giant, wow, how you buy you that nice house? Always spending that high amount, what you wearing is high in now. The road, they'll come to know that it's nothing though, but it's funny, yo, you got a money phone, cause the contacts is lost as you, he's gone.
Money isn't something that you live for, every time you want it, just a little more.
Started to call, a fall in a flame, but kind of ironic, cause suddenly shifted from flying to fall. It's funny how everyone thinking they're poor, thinking their life ain't worth living at all. Go and visit some kids in a...
The best track so far.
Yeah, the wordplay, the flow on that was great.
Flow was good.
Heaps better.
I like the beat. It was actually a poppy hip hop beat that I quite enjoyed.
Yep.
I didn't like the hook once again.
Nope.
But agreed. Yeah.
Yep. Same with thoughts.
So but yeah, the best track so far. Yep. I liked his wordplay on here and his flow.
Agreed. Agreed. Witness.
Would he be disgusted? Would he be proud? It ain't about the choices that you shouldn't have made. It's about what you did when they could have been made. See, I'm dancing with the devil, one foot in the grave. The eyes are windows to your soul, take a look at my pain. It's all about the risks that you're looking at. I don't rate success in the numbers, I am pain. I rate it from people just telling me their lives were saved. Wasn't the person the media would try to paint. Haters read the headlines, fans read the entire page. God is my witness, I'll be damned if I'm afraid for forgiveness. I don't know if I ever can gather the strength to grab it and face up to it and get my hand to reach it. Every time I just lose my fucking mind, whilst it stands over me again and again, and I'm trapped beneath it to make my...
I also think that was one of the better tracks. I like the message. I like how he seems sincere. And I think he was saying something that obviously meant quite a bit to him. And I respect that. And I think he delivered it decently. Minus the singing.
Agreed.
Agreed!
Good message. Decent execution. Next.
If you wanna know that just us, me, 1 minute of dumb bastard, and suddenly I'm off marker, you a masochist. No breaking jaws. You know it's gonna hurt, but you take some more. How can you stop a killer who doesn't break the law? Mind control, you can fight it, but I'll make you fall. My spirit. Cause no one loves it like they trust you.
Fucking stop that shit! Holy fuck! Holy fucking shit! Oh. Oh.
It's a favorite track, right?
Yeah. Makes the Holocaust seem fun.
Come on, bruh. Jeez.
Oh.
Yeah, look, our body language says it all. Next track.
That was trash.
Body language.
I'm fucking done! Fuck this shit! I'm done!
I think he actually left the warehouse, not just the studio.
Is it over?
Look.
Is this as bad as I thought it was?
Look,
That's gonna be mad.
The hook, obviously, was not good. The verses were okay.
Don't give a fuck.
The verses were actually okay.
When the production's that bad and the hook's that bad, I don't give a fuck about your message.
Well. Coop de Grace. Yo, designer! Close the fucking door, boy!
Hey.
They wanna know where six at.
Okay, okay. I'm
with this track that would like to retire. The fact is I hate rappers as well. I'd rather battle myself and fight fire with fire.
Okay.
When I'm saying that my song of the major, what I'm trying to say is you get lost in it, ain't bruh. Honestly, with the quality we're dropping, if you wanted to grade us, it's gotta be A plus. I ain't listening to hip hop these days. Everybody just a bunch of hip hop cliches. You see me drift off into outer space. Are you down to earth rappers, skinny sour grapes? You're a sour steak. Old fucking fringes out of date. Rocked up to the studio an hour late. Snuck in like, hey guys, it sounded great. It's cool with a groovy, be even stupider. Screw the tutor, I'm off and a tutor, blowing a cubicle, eating you and I'm cake. And I think it's part of my uvula. All I wanted to do was to rap and improve and do better. Boosting up on my skills, but like, you didn't get the newsletter. Now I just wanna ruin your boss. I'm a fucking nuke. If you should evacuate from the place, I'm gone nuclear. So fuck me, the shop is full of the shit. That's crap, it's step.
Who would have thought the best thing so far in a 360 album would be a Sis Century feature? I think that an artist with a whole album would have his own best part of the album.
Oh, right. Yeah. That was the dopest track.
It was the best track so far.
The production was great. Really, it's like a New York kind of vibe right there. The trumpets, I don't know what that was. It's like bouncy.
I don't know. It was definitely the best track so far.
Admission.
See, I learned more from one time failing than all of my success combined. So no stress now. When everything can set south, but a heart you wanna end up, in time you'll be sent down. It comes and goes, but a friend is forever. Understand time is money, go and spend it together. Chasing the stars, endeavour together, and get your team out the matrix, Nebuchadnezzar. Keep kind of messages that send it. Instead of stepping to our problem, we're pretending. Instead of owning our mistakes, we get defensive. We can't even talk these days without a thing.
Now that's the best track right there.
Looking in the mirror.
Where's this been? This is a really good track. It's a really good track. What's with the first 7-8 tracks of trash? Terrible fucking beats. Where's all this been? Give me an album of this.
Great. Better if it is him. That's much better singing than before. Hey, you know what?
Yo.
Hey, for real. No bullshit. That was a really good track.
Touching, great message, great violin.
Great delivery,
keys,
production.
I don't get the bass though. The bass was out of place. I don't know why there was so much bass. I don't know if that was us or if that's the way it was designed. That's my only fault with that track, the bass. The bass felt off. But everything else, fucking awesome. If you did the whole, like, I know, you've been saying a lot in this album so far. Don't get me wrong, I may be shitting on a lot of this album, but like, so far, each of your tracks have had actually good content message-wise and also a lot of fun message play, wordplay as well. It's just the production I can't get behind. I just hate the production. But if you had all of your tracks beforehand with production like this...
Oh, bro.
I'd fuck with the whole album.
Oh, bro.
That's just me.
And he was so sincere, too. Like, the delivery is great.
Oh, beautiful track. Beautiful, beautiful track.
100%. Great job, 360.
Thank you for bringing me back to reality.
Third last track, Trouble, featuring Gary Clark.
Yeah,
it's like hate's been popularized. Love turns to hate at the drop of a dime. I see my own fans crossing the line, but if they're fans of hate, I don't want them as mine. Look, a burqa is not a disguise. It's foreign to you, so it's a shock in your mind. All you need to do is spend some quality time with them to know they just want to live a positive life. See, that's the nature of humankind. Yeah, but the shit in the Middle East is still going on, where the acts are disgusting. If you ever raise a fact on a subject, all we ever do is attack and get upset. If you want to evolve and help the problems to solve, stop bickering and have the discussion. What a joke, people killing each other over a book, and they suffer a lot for land. I love some of the scriptures, but fuck a religion, cause I'm suddenly thinking and I'm asking. Why the truth of God is bad? Go accept that it's right. The court of religion's fundamentally right. And the Bible might work as a general guide, but a story that's told over centuries, surely it's eventually gonna get it better with lies.
That's, okay. I like that ending. That's a very provocative statement at the end.
Yes. It was a great message. I can get behind it. I definitely agree with it. Someone who's grown up heavily with religion and had like a big distaste towards it because of the amount of deaths and just mindless shit that people have done. So I get it. It's a really good message. I just hate the beat and the hook's trash.
Fair enough. I like how people approach these subjects that make other people uncomfortable. I like that.
I like the way that you tackled it, the way about like how a lot of people in this country come here and then a lot of Australians just treat them like shit because of what they see in the media or what you know, what religions like sort of face them and everything in regards. So it's sort of tackling both sides of that. So yeah, I love the message of this track. It's a really good message.
Tiny Angel.
So this story is about a really close friend of mine.
It's about me.
I love you, brother.
My mates talk shit about their wives, but I love mine. Yeah, we fight sometimes, but ain't that just life? She's been pregnant now for some time. That was true. 2 months by. My wife called me up while I was working at the pub, right? She told me I was gonna be a daddy. We both broke down. She said there's something that I'd done right. To boy. My little ray of sunshine, it dawned on me. I can't wait to see my sun rise. You know what they say about time though? It does fly. Fast forward 9 months and suddenly it's crunch time. Pain like an anthem interruption. Like someone's got a knife and they stab at her stomach. She's like, we have to do something. The nurse said it's natural, relax. It's just a sign that it's actually coming. She's like, no, it's too much. It's too hard to get it out. I'm saying any words I think will help her calming her down. Now, then I'm shocked by the massive scream she lets out. The doctor's like, yes, now the head's out. And then I watch as he quickly pulling the rest out. It's so amazing to see my son in the flesh. I can't help but notice he hasn't taken a breath now. They put a little plastic thing in his mouth while the doctor's 2 fingers are slightly pumping his chest down. I start panicking. Something's going wrong. They push me to the side. I can barely see what's going on. Everyone's in shock. I'm just listening in, holding my breath, wishing I could give it to him. Fuck. At 20 minutes, now they're stopping. They turn around, they say we've lost him. It's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen, but there's no life in him. My wife's crying, like, why aren't they reviving him? I said they tried for 20 minutes, she's like, try again. Now I'm feeling like I'm stuck in hell. This is the worst pain I've fucking felt. I believed in God, but now I feel dumb as hell. Can someone please stop God to go and fucking self? Died from asphyxiation, no air in his lungs. The parents should never have to bury their son. And it's killing me, the Christmas time is barely in a month. So I'm doing what I have to do to spend it with my son.
Where the fuck did that come from? That was fucking grim as fuck. Holy shit. It seems like he's coming from the perspective of his friend, because he said at the start of the track, this is goes out to a close friend of mine. It's like, yeah, exactly. This track is amazing for how much passion goes into, but there's a part of me thinking like, what? How does this help someone that goes through this? Like, imagine if you've gone through something similar to this. Would you want to relive that? Like, rapping about being so excited for a child and then, you know, having a child and then a stillbirth and then going through all that emotion. Like, why? To me, why would you rap about that for people to relive that?
Well, what about death? We rap about death all the time. We've heard Killer Mike and LP do it. We've heard Kendrick, we've heard everyone do it. Like, we relive, we tell stories of our pain and suffering.
Yeah, that's a good point. I just feel like it'd be really...
like, traumatic, like, to hear it again?
Yeah.
Because it's so vivid.
It's so vivid, and also at the same time, there's no... And I think it's also a great track after last track, because the last track was all about, you know...
I love that track. It was incredibly vulnerable, vivid. I love story. I think he storytelled extremely well. It had me transfixed the whole time, and it made me even emotional, because, you know, I relate, you know, I don't know, it's like I imagine myself in that situation, and then I feel like, man, that could happen to anybody, you know, like, what if that was me, what if that was with my partner? Like, the amount of pain and suffering you'd feel is too immense to describe. And so I don't know if that track is meant to so much help people as it's meant to just get it out of you, to help yourself.
I'm still like, but so do you reckon his friend would have told him about it, and then he would have felt,
no idea.
And then he would have felt. No, this is suspected, but like thinking, like, do you think that like his friend would have told him, And then like he would have felt so much pain for his friend that he had to say the story.
Maybe.
But how would he know? I guess his friend would have told him, and then he would, I don't know. It's just like,
You question the intent behind it.
Yeah, I question the intent. Like, even if you're just trying to get it out, I just feel like this track, as beautiful as imagining it and how much emotion it brings to you, what good is it doing?
I think it's doing good by letting people feel empathy, and like feel what it's like. By through music, you can feel what it would be like for you to live through that. I feel like that's helpful.
No, that's a very good point.
To see through some of those perspectives. But I'm trying to understand behind it.
Yeah,
for sure. That's good. That's
end of the day, really well delivered, very emotional, very raw. Could have done without the ending. I thought it should have ended like...
I think he was trying to do some like Kanye dark fantasy with the auto-tune. Like,
nah, it didn't work. But everything else, yeah, really, really good track.
All right, last one, Letters.
When a baby girl's gonna take on your name. There's a future you could go and write a letter to yourself. Imagine all the shit that it would say. Next you can send a letter my way. I might have to guess what the letter might say. If you could see who your words would become. Make sure your father's proud of everything his son's become. I realize that God's up and if you're stubborn, but listen to your fam when they're telling you you're fucking up. So then you go and find your own wife. You need to have your own lives. Have each other's back so you both strive.
That's not a bad ending. That was a thoughtful track. The latter half of this album seems much better than the first 60-70%.
1,000,000% better.
1,000,000, wow.
Yeah. I liked like 3 tracks on this album. Nearly every track of this album has a good message. Either has an uplifting message, a positive message, a really emotional, sad message, or just like with some fun wordplay in a message. So
yeah, something that makes you think.
It's definitely the best part of this album. He's definitely showing that he is very relatable. Because he's
a great point.
His storytelling has been on point, but he also does it in a way which is funny or just simply to get across. Like he doesn't try and mix his lyrics up too
much. It caters well to the Australian culture.
It caters well to the Australian culture, it caters well to people. He kind of like, I don't want to relate him to like good artists, but I just think that he has a very simple way of storytelling, and it's just like a way that most people out there that don't want to have to
don't
look like Jay-Z, triple entendres and stuff. Like it's more just like you're listening and you feel it.
Yeah,
you
exactly. Don't have to think too much. That's a great point. And that's the music for those types of people. Mm. Production's the low light. That's the
honestly the hooks is the worst.
Yeah.
The hooks were worse than the production. I don't think there's one good hook in this album. Not one. And the track's the one that I like the most, I don't even think had a hook.
Mm.
Some of the production was good. I mean, the production of this album probably was good, but it's just with the indie pop feel throughout the whole album.
You didn't enjoy it.
I didn't enjoy it. It's not for me. The production was fine, it's just not for me.
I'm a little more okay with that type of music, but it's not my preference.
All in all, I'm glad that I heard this and realized that 360 is still spreading a lot of good messages. Because that's good for the hip-hop scene, it's good for Australia. But on the downside, I just really want some Australian artists to just, you know, have more creative sounds. I want people to be like, to look to Australia and be like, there's this new sound coming out of Australia. I'm sick of people trying to ride this pop indie wave or trying to ride this new trap wave.
Yeah.
Like, if you're out there and you're making music in Australia and it's not something that you've thought of, that you're either stealing someone else's sound or you're trying to incorporate or sort of make someone else's sound but make it more like you. Fuck that shit.
But hold up, Logic did that.
What?
Logic did that.
Yeah, but Logic's dope as fuck though.
So you're saying you can do it, but you have to be really special.
You have to pull it off.
Dude,
Logic, when he released fucking Young Sinatra 1, his second mixtape after Young Broken Infamous, that captivated me. Actually, I'm pretty sure nearly like 3/4 of the album is other people's beats, but he just spat so raw in there. Like, Black were zombies. They're so different. I just want Australia to have some artists to come out that just just so apart from the rest. They can still do messages like 360 to it, but do it in a really bizarre or different way, with a really different way musically as well. That's all I want. That's all I want.
It's completely fair enough. I resonate with that message, and I hear, hear. Jungle beats.
Jungle motherfucking beats.
Rocking black on black with the hat to match. Smoking back to back to my lingo flat. Where the fuck we at? Where the fuck we at? Where the stars is at? Where the stars is at?